Ramadan Gobi, the Permanent Secretary and Secretary to the Treasury, met remarks while appearing before Parliament's Public Accounts Committee to respond to the audit queries raised in the 2021-2022 Auditor General's report for the Treasury operations, cited a decision taken by Parliament recently to alter allocations meant for clearing some of Uganda's debt, saying such scenarios leave the Ministry of Finance with no choice but to ask for supplementary budgets in order to meet government's obligations.
They are statutory payments, for example. We know whether we like or not, in a year, we must pay our debt as the first call on the budget. So when Parliament cuts some of the money to pay debt on assumption that it has been overprovided and in disregard of our explanation with the figures and facts that we have provided to the dot, there is no overprovision. You have created supplementary.
Gobi cited a scenario where Parliament rejected approval of money allocated to payment of commission on grounds that the amount had overgrown, saying there is no way the Treasury will default on such a payment.
July, which we are running, you removed some money for what they call commitment fees. That, you know, this money has grown, it's now too much. Let us remove some. But you know, we are going to pay these commitment fees. So when time comes and you have to pay because the projects have not performed yet, there's no way you can default on it as a treasury.
However, the Secretary to the Treasury confessed that politics is another factor escalating supplementary budgets. He says it was irregular for the government to allocate funds to Atiak Sugar Factory through a supplementary budget because it was not unforeseeable. Gobi called for a consensus on the industrial policy to guide with strategic investments.
For example, industrial policy. Usually it is where you have very serious arguments in some areas. Should we invest in Atiaka Sugar? Should we not invest in Atiaka Sugar? Government is saying invest in Atiaka Sugar. Government right from the head of state. And Parliament says, no, we are not investing in Atiaka Sugar because they have not done this and this and this.
Gobi disclosed that government agencies are causing supplementary budgets due to poor planning. He explained that accounting officers deliberately prioritize less important activities in their budget and push for funding of critical items through supplementary budgets.
Three, responsible for guiding the planning and budgeting. We have brought in the reform of repurposing budget. So as we are budgeting, we ask entities to redistribute money, not to think that you are just going to get more money every year. You must justify the priorities.
However, his submission attracted mixed reactions from members of parliament, as some faulted the Ministry of Finance for going for a fishing expenditure to cover up its mistakes.
You're not the ones who go and get money from where Parliament appropriated and give it to another vote, because you cannot pass supplementary without indicating with the source of the resources.
Appropriate, when we appropriate, finance calls it a distortion, that we are distorting their budget. They go ahead and do whatever they want. So does the PSST stand by that statement? And if we look at the previous year's budget, did the finance release money in accordance with what Parliament appropriated?
Raising. He says there are statutory obligations. You come here in Parliament with over seriousness, you say they are wrong without empirical evidence. And they go, because they are statutory, there will be a charge to the consolidated fund. Immediately there and then, that is what? A supplementary. Only thing to ask Auditor General to confirm that. That is it true that there were no statutory obligations we deducted?
In the just concluded financial year 2022-2023, 2.9 trillion shillings was appropriated for expenditure through supplementary budgets. Report compiled by Fred Kajibi for the news.